Okay, the gentleman from South Carolina, Mr. Gowdy, has the balance of the time.
I thank the gentleman. Mr. Holder, there were a series of wiretap applications made to the Department of Justice in Fast and Furious. Do you recall how many?
No.
Several. Would you disagree with that?
I'm sorry.
Several?
I don't know how many, but I have to say that with regard to discussions of wiretaps, there is a limited amount of information that I'm going to be able to share in this forum.
Right, and I'm not going to ask you anything that's going to get you in trouble with a federal judge.
Please don't.
Those applications are voluminous, they're long, and there are factual predicates to support the application for a wiretap, correct?
Speaking just generally, and not, don't get
right.
me wrong, I'm not getting in any trouble here. Speaking generally, that's accurate.
Are you convinced there is no discussion of gun walking in any of those T3 applications?
I can't get into the specifics.
Have you read them?
I have not read them, but I can't.
Who approves them? Whose division is that? Is that the criminal division?
It's in the criminal division.
That would be Mr. Brewer?
No, he only approves roving wiretaps.
Is he the head of the criminal division?
Right, but there are no roving wiretaps in Operation Fast and Furious.
But there are several wiretaps.
Yeah, wiretaps would...
That have long factual predicates supporting the application.
I have not seen them, but I make that assumption.
And you haven't read them, so you can't say whether or not yet another Department of Justice official would have been put on notice that gun walking was part of Fast and Furious.
I can't say that, but you cannot say it either.
No, I can't.
You cannot say the converse.
No, I can't. Who does Mr. Weitch report to?
Who does Mr.
Weitch?
Ron Weitch?
Yeah.
I guess on the Justice Department chart, probably through the Deputy Attorney General to me.
Well, what I'm trying to get at, your defense of your friend Lanny Brewer, I guess at some level, is admirable. I just don't understand it. It took me a minute to get you to admit that he knew that guns were being walked, and there are scores of emails where he admitted it. He assigned a prosecutor to Fast and Furious. This is someone who on his own website boasts of being one of the best 100 lawyers in America. He knew that guns were being walked. He assigned a prosecutor to Fast and Furious. He forwarded an email to his home computer of a draft of Mr. Weitch's letter. And he's going to stick around, Mr. Attorney General?
Well, you're saying things here, see, but you're doing what I asked you to not do before, and that is conflating things. I said he knew about, and he admitted that he knew about gun walking when it came to Operation Wide Receive.
Well, Mr. Holder, the letter is very specific. ATF makes every effort to interdict weapons that have been purchased illegally and prevent their transportation to Mexico. Is that true or false?
That is not accurate, but Mr. Brewer didn't, as he indicated, he said he did not have anything to do with the creation.
He forwarded this letter, a draft of it, to his home computer. Now, it does not take a long walk to get that he forwarded it to his home computer to read it.
I'm only going by what Mr. Brewer has testified to, which is that he did not think that he reviewed the letter, reviewed the drafts before they went out. That is what he
But you agree with me.
Mr. Chairman, with regular order, Mr. Chairman.
The witness should be allowed to finish.
Would the gentleman from Nevada be willing to further yield?
The gentleman from South Carolina has the time.
I'd be happy to yield to the gentleman from California.